Hi and welcome back to my series, Desensitising Your Dog to a Pet Blower. This is final product, so we've got to this point that we're now going to have the pet blower up at its highest level and we're going to give a quick simulation to the dog of what it's going to be like to be used. So this will be whether or not your dog's being groomed and it's being dry, or the main case that I'm going to be using it for at the moment will be to help with his blow and coat. So we want to see how the dog reacts when it is up high. Now I suspect his ears will probably go back a little bit. He'll have a little bit of anxiety, a little bit of discomfort, and that's okay. It's important to keep an eye on the dog. If the dog will still take treats, even if the ears are back and it's a little bit uncomfortable, a little bit tense, that's okay. That's a really good indication. If a dog will still eat, then the stress levels are manageable and it's just fine. So you just keep it going. You let the dog know, yes, that's good, when it's remaining calm. Give it a treat. You know, act like there's nothing to worry about. And over time, the dog will understand that. So it'll get better as long as you follow that and keep a close eye. Now, if the dog starts whimpering or crying, if the dog starts pulling away or trying to run away, if your dog goes to bite at the lead or at the blower, at itself or at your hands or anything like that, then the stress or the stimulation or the aggression, whatever it is causing the issue, is too much for the dog. Simply put, your dog's not dealing with it. So what you need to do is stop. Now don't go into a panic, don't make a big fuss about it, remain calm, simply put the blower down, control the dog, put the blower down, turn it off. Without saying a word to your dog, get up, take the dog outside. If you were doing this outside, then simply walk away from the blower, play a game. Take the lead off, play a game. Have a bit of fun with the dog and just chill. And then when the dog's de-stressed, back to normal, come back in, reintroduce the blower to the dog, and then start going back through from touch onwards again. So build it back up, because your dog, it just means your dog wasn't ready. So the main thing is you act calm and confident and just like there is nothing out of the ordinary. There's not an issue. If you start, you know, grabbing at your dog, going, oh, you poor baby, and making a fuss of it, or panicking yourself, the dog will feel that, the dog will pick it up, and then the dog will believe that what it felt, the fear it felt, or the anxiety it felt, or the aggression that it felt was justified, and that'll begin to teach the dog what it felt, what it did, was what it should be doing. Alright, if you remain calm and neutral and confident, the dog will start doubting what it was getting upset about. It'll be like, he's not worried. And that'll help the dog. It won't escalate, and that's what you want. Game is about keeping the dog's emotions under control and teaching the dog to be calm and confident. And that's what this is about. If you show fear, if you show emotion, if you start babying the dog because it's a little bit scared, then that simply teaches the dog it was right. There is really something to be scared about, or there's really something to be defensive about, or there's really something to be aggressive about. If the dog starts showing abnormal signs, then simply put it down calmly, turn it off, walk out or walk away, play a game with your dog like nothing ever happened. Because it didn't. There's nothing that the dog needs to fear here. And that's what you have to teach the dog. So, on high, and we're going to go. Again, I'll be just kneeling on the cord because I don't want him running off if he freaks out. Alright, because then I set him back. So I'm going to keep him under control. Again, it's important to watch his body language, my body language, and the interactions that we have and don't have. Alright, that's really important. Like I said, I expect that the ears will go back a little bit. I expect he's going to be a little uncomfortable. Why wouldn't he be? It's all new. It's a bit scary. It's a bit noisy. Things are hitting him you can't even see. I expect that. And if that's all it is, and he can still take treats, and he can still listen to me if I ask him to, he's okay. And we work through that, and that'll get better and better each time. If he starts wanting to get up, or any other signs there that are worse than that, then we need to stop. Alright?
Good boy.
Okay, so you can see there, there's a little bit of anxiety, there's a little bit of uncertainty. Ears were back a little bit, but he was still reacting when I said his name. He was still eating. There's no aggression in the ante. It's still his normal, very gentle self. Once I started brushing his body with his hand, I felt the body relax a little bit. And as you can see, he's back to normal as soon as it's finished over. So there is a little bit of anxiety there. And like I said, that's fine. You expect that. This is all new. You expect that there's going to be a little bit there. That's as much as I like to have. If it gets any more than that, it was slightly turned away from me as well. Any more than that, and I would pull back to the next level. A few more little short sessions like this, and that body language will change a little bit more and be a little bit more positive. And by the time he's finished blowing his coat, which is what I'm going to be using it for, it's just going to be an everyday occurrence to him. So, but like I said, if your dog reacts badly, if it gets worse than that, if the dog starts crying or whimpering, pulling away, wanting to get away, keep it controlled, keep your dog controlled, but put the blower down, turn it off, be calm, stay calm, don't interact, just walk out, have a game like it's any other day. Alright, so I hope this helps, and trust me, it will help the dog. Once you desensitize your dog and your dog's not stressing out over, you know, getting groomed or anything like that, it makes the dog's life much nicer. And this works along with other things as well. All right, until next time, I hope this helps. We'll see you.